Hi guys, I thought it might be a good idea now to actually put some skills to use and actually build a slightly more functional API. So what I'm going to do is follow a AWS tutorial. And this means that when you actually do this on your own, then if you have any issues, it's a bit easier to go back and look at the documentation and make sure that you've done it correctly. So what this will do is it's going to build a Hello World API with Lambda proxy integration. And what's going to happen is when it returns a response, it's going to have a greeting, and we're actually going to modify the time, the name, the city, and the day. So it's actually going to return a relevant result to us. So it's quite easy to set up, and we should have a bit of fun with this. And hopefully this will help to solidify some of the skills we've learned up to now in this section. The first thing we're going to do is we need to head over to Lambda. We're going to create a function. I'm going to call this get started Lambda proxy integration. We're going to keep Node.js selected, and we can use an existing role. I'm just going to use my Lambda basic execution role, and that should be okay. And let's create function. I'm then going to copy some code. So there's some code which you'll find in the article here. You can just click on copy, come back, delete out all the code in there. Let's not make a mistake. And then put in all the code and just click on save. We're now going to go to API Gateway, and we're going to create an API. We're going to choose REST, choose build. We'll call this Lambda simple proxy. It's going to be a regional endpoint, and then just choose create API. We then need to create a resource. So this is going to be what's called the Hello World resource. So choose create resource, put in Hello World, and leave the other settings and just choose create resource. We're now going to set up an any method. So choose create method and choose any. Remember, this is like a catch-all. You don't have to specify a specific verb. Now we're going to leave it as Lambda function. We're going to use proxy integration, and we should be able to find our get started Lambda proxy integration. And what you can do there is just type space and then you'll see the list. So that's all we need to do. Let's click on save. And then this is going to grant API Gateway permission to invoke the function. So that's fine. So that's the API set up and the Lambda function configured. If we go back to the tutorial, we can now see there's a couple of ways we can test. So one way is we can do a GET request using a URL and then adding onto that URL some code at the end here. So we just have name equals and city equals. So let's use our invoke URL here. I'm going to open that in a new tab. And you'll get a message saying missing authentication token. That's okay. Let's type forward slash hello world, because this is our resource. And then I'm going to do question mark name equals Neil and city equals Sydney. And let's hit enter. And so now we get this response. And at the top here, you can see the message, good day, Neil of Sydney. So that means everything's working. Another way we can check this is all working is via the command line. So to do that, you can take this command here and then you can change the content. So what you need to do is change your name and your city, and you can change the day and the time of day as well. And then of course, don't forget to change your actual invoke URL to get to the correct endpoint as well. So I'm going to copy this code, and back in the command line here, I'm going to paste it in. And I need to go back and get my invoke URL. So back in the API Gateway console, I'm going to copy my invoke URL and let's backspace. And I'm going to delete all of this out of here, paste in my invoke URL, and then make sure I've got that slash there. And then I'm going to change some of these parameters. So let's change name equals Neil, city equals Sydney, and it's a Tuesday today. So let's change this to Tuesday, and I'm going to put it as morning. So that's our command. Let's see if we can run this command. And sure enough, that works successfully. And at the bottom here, you can see we get the message, good morning, Neil of Sydney, happy Tuesday. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed that. And in the next lesson, we're going to do a very similar example, but we're going to do a non-proxy configuration instead.